Joining us on Hot Copy, Labor Chief Bienvenido Laguesma. Secretary Laguesma, good morning. Thank you so much for joining us in the program.
Good morning, Mike, and good morning also to your televiewers and followers. And also thank you for this opportunity to be part of your program.
All right, Secretary, how are the first few days of your stint as, Labor Chief? How different is this from your previous post under the time of former President Era?
No, I would like to compare it with my private life. Mm-hmm. This is tougher than my private life.
I can imagine. Mm-hmm. How tough?
This is also a welcome opportunity because I am being given the privilege and opportunity to once again contribute my share in public service. No, and hopefully I will be able to live up to the expectations of President Bongbong Marcos that I can be a contributor dun sa kanyang pangarap na ang bayan ay babagong muli. At this can be done when the Department of Labor and Employment is able to really whip up itself, no, as a mean serving and responsible machine, always mindful na services to the public, especially to the workers and the employers, will be first and foremost the obligation of our department.
Mm-hmm. Let me just ask you, Secretary Laguesma, how different is this from your time during President Era? Because at that time, you were coming off a recession, a global recession in 1997. You were Secretary of Labor from 1998 to 2001. How about now? We're also coming off from a pandemic.
Well, I cannot at this point immediately compare, no, because we are just in office for 1 week. But based on our first cabinet meeting, I can see and I can feel that President Bongbong Marcos is dead serious in really moving and pushing the cabinet secretaries to be able to deliver their share so that we can also be able to realize ano ba yung mga programa na dapat nating itulong sa bahagi ng ating mga departamento, particularly the Department of Labor and Employment, doon nga sa nabanggit ko na ang direksyon, yung bayan babangon muli, yun ang aming sinusundan, no? Kasi yung unang direktiba ng ating Pangulong Marcos, work together, no? You should have unity in purpose, unity in direction, and that we are able to really, in unison, we'll be able to address concerns ng ating pong sambayanan. Again, to repeat, as far as the Department of Labor and Employment, I see and I consider that a marching order to really do our utmost best, no, to alleviate yung situation ng ating mga manggagawa at also be able to help yung ating employer sector who actually are the ones responsible for creating and generating more jobs.
Mm-hmm. Were there specific instructions, Secretary Laguesma, during your first cabinet meeting with respect to the Labor Department? Because when asked during the press conference, he did say there were specific recommendations for each of the agencies, but there were too many to mention, each agency having their own functions. What concrete steps did the president mention during that cabinet meeting?
Actually, yung more specific directives nakatuon dun sa mga nagpresenta ng kanilang departamento. And I'm referring to the Department of Agriculture. Yun, presidente mismo ang nag-report at sinabi yung kanyang direksyon. No? That's something for me. No? That's if I compare that, ito, isa sa mga kaibahan, no? Mike, no? Presidente mismo taking on the Department of Agriculture, considering yung mga challenges sa mga dapat na harapin at sikasuhin, lalo na may kinalaman sa food security. Secondly, yung DOTR, no, medyo mahigpit ang riyan ng ating ding Pangulo, DICT, which covers all department, no, yung DICT in terms of digitalization. No, kasi the objective is that you actually eliminate, if not or avoid, yung discretion, too much discretion on the part of those serving in government so that hindi masyadong matagal ang serbisyo. No? If we are able to digitalize majority of our services, especially those that needs to be promptly delivered expeditiously sa ating mga clientele or constituency, I think we have done a lot. No? So, part of also of the directive is that the president is giving us free hand to either streamline, reorganize, introduce structural reforms, no? And I think he has shown the example. He is leading by example. Yung kanyang inabolish, binuwag na niya yung PICC, PCCO, and then trying to put avoid duplication ng mga function, which also means duplication of resources.
Mm-hmm. Secretary Legwesma, in your department, is there a need to restructure? Are you seeing some reforms that you will be introducing in the next 6 years?
Ang unang tingin namin siguro, we'll have to revisit also the provisions of the labor code kasi in 74 vintage na yan. I and you know that there are piecemeal amendments.
Yes.
And some of these piecemeal amendments, medyo hindi sa tugma kung ano sa dapat magkaroon ng commonality ng direksyon. Sekmay, no? Kuhari, may provision ka sa book 4 on wages, safety, etc. Dapat tumugma din siya doon sa book 5 na labor relations, no? Hindi pwede na iba ang sinasabi rito tapos dito ang sa implementasyon magkakaproblema. I think that can be a source of friction between labor and management, no? So that's one direction. The other one which can be immediate is that we are now reviewing issuances na medyo hindi nakakasala sa labat o merong nagre-result na confusion, and we'll try to simplify this for the benefit especially of our ordinary workers, no? Bahagi yan. And then we are now in the process of crafting a labor and employment plan, no? Tatagos hanggang sa term ng presidente 2022 to 2028, no? And there will be deliverables also, but we have not fixed this because the labor and employment plan will have to be subjected to consultation, dialogues with the affected sectors. And I'm talking about the labor sector and the employer sector and other stakeholders who might be affected or who might be interested to put in their contributions or input as we finalize, no, the labor and employment plan. I also, part of that would be our engaging international organizations like the International Labor Organization.
Secretary Legasma, let's talk about the latest report from the Philippine Statistics Authority about unemployment numbers in the Philippines. So you have now 6% unemployment rate for the month of May 2020. That's up from 5.7% in April 2022. What do you think would account for this, considering that we have been lifting our restrictions in mobility and in terms of the number of people in institutions or establishments?
Mike, basically and mainly, I see the addition coming from the new entrants. Yung mga fresh graduates kasama dyan na naghahanap ng trabaho, hindi kagad nakakita ng trabaho.
So, they're counted already in June?
Ito, merong dinaanan dyan eh, kasi different stages eh. Di ba merong mga pumasok na sa ating workforce, labor force natin ng March, April, no? So lumabas ng May, no? At ang comparative period kasi normally na ginagawa namin ay tignan yung May 2021. Mas mataas siya, 7.7. And then May 2022, mas mababa siya. Pero dahil ang mga naragdag na employment dyan siguro sa akin palagay, mga short term eh. Dahil you are very familiar that we just through with the election process, no?
Yes.
Maraming mga temporary, mga short-term na trabaho at yan eh medyo nawala na. While having said that, ang medyo serious concern din namin is the quality of jobs, no? Kasi if we compare comparative figures, yung underemployment rate medyo mataas.
14.5%.
Yes, that means there are many who'd like to see to work more, no, and earn more. But unfortunately and sadly, hindi nila makita yung trabaho. You mentioned about restriction, no? Eh medyo bumabalik na naman tayo dahil sana wag na, no? Na tumataas na naman ang mga new cases, no? That's why we keep on repeating na while we are relaxing, easing the restrictions, continue to observe strict health protocols, no? This is not actually being done as a limitation to your freedom to move. But rather, it's also, I think, protecting you, your health and safety is principally important, no, for government, most especially for the Department of Labor and Employment, if it refers to the workers and the employers. Kasi a single or even a few infections in the company doing face-to-face work will also mean, you know, possible closure ng kumpanya in the meantime, mm-hmm, para medyo i-assure na yung mga manggagawa hindi natatakot, hindi nangangamba na pagpasok nila, pag-uwi nila, may daladala sila na makakahawa sa mga pamilya, membro ng kanilang pamilya.
Talk about health restrictions, Secretary Laguesma. Are you going to support calls for mandatory vaccinations of workers? Will this include a booster shot, the definition or redefinition of vaccination, fully vaccination, to include the third dose, booster shot?
Mike, that's always a sensitive and emotional issue, no? Mm-hmm. But ako personally, I believe in the value na magkaroon ka ng bakuna. Especially because I consider myself, I'm a senior citizen, Mike, as you can see, no? Mm-hmm. So nakita ko ang benepisyo, no? But of course, we respect people, those who would actually more or less a reason out why they are averse to being vaccinated, either on religious ground or they have certain comorbidities that can be exacerbated or aggravated. But at the end of the day, by and large, ako ay support na dapat mabakunahan po ang ating mga manggagawa, lalo na ang membro ng kanilang pamilya. At nakakapanghinayang na ma-miss natin ang opportunity because as I understand, vaccines procure earlier, mm-hmm, about fire, no? And sayang, this could be may mga pakinabang na mas mahalaga o mas matimbang, no? Compared to doon sa mga apprehensions or mga sinasabi ng mga negative results or side effects na masama doon sa mga nababakunahan, no? So basically, sana matignan ng ating mga kasamahan ng mga manggagawa, lalo na ang kahalagahan ng pagkakaroon ng bakuna.
But Secretary, as Secretary of Labor, what immediate steps will you do about this matter? Are you going to raise this in discussions with labor groups, with employers, if there's going to be a mandate for vaccination or even for the third dose at least?
We'll certainly do, Mike, because one of the principles that deeply enshrined as a Department of Labor and Employment that I would really like to push through is the spirit of consultation, dialogue with its social partners, no, labor and management. And you know, we also operate on the principle of tripartism. Each of the parties, government, labor and management, has to have a say, no, in crafting plans that would affect and benefit them, no. Hindi pwede na it's always imposed obligation, you know, mandatory. Dapat mayroon silang ownership, Mike. Eh. I think we have to have stronger consensus building strategies. And I have started to do that as I come back to the department. This is my first week, but I have done consultations with the labor groups, even if I have not been officially inducted into office, no? Yesterday, I did meet with the representatives of the Employers Confederation of the Philippines, PCCI, PhilExport, and related groups. And we had a good discussion on how the employer sector can actually help government support programs that would also benefit the workers at the end of the day, because as I said, they should consider themselves as social partners, and so we should always be cooperating. And also, there will always be situations where there will be differences, but mm-hmm, we will continue to build consensus, no? Iwasan yung may nagdi-desisyon o merong umaatras kagad, engage, we will engage them. And hopefully, we will be able to deliver the point that cooperation, unity, yung pagkakaisa na team ng ating Pangulong Bongbong Marcos, ay may direksyon siyang pinupuntahan upang yung kanyang pangarap na ang bayan babangon muli magkaroon ng katuparan.
Mm-hmm. Secretary Laguesma, let me just go back to the figures from the Philippine Statistics Authority. This time on the breakdown of our workforce, you have 59% in the services sector. That's about 46 million, 22% in agriculture, 19% in the industry sector. Now, is this the ideal ratio for our workforce? Because you have President Bongbong Marcos saying he wants emphasis on agriculture and industry. So are we going to see a bigger share of workers in the agriculture and industry sectors in the coming years? Is that part of your plan?
Yeah, I think part of the plan is that we'd like to develop, we'd like to see decent, long-lasting jobs, no? Yung hindi man sa perpetual quality jobs, Mike. And we can see this dun sa nagbibigay ng magandang pakinabang. Manufacturing sector, I think we have to revisit policies on that, no? And as you pointed out, the President Bongbong Marcos has took on the hit, no? Inanunakagad niya yung Department of Agriculture, no? He could have appointed somebody of his trust and confidence, but he personally took it upon himself na asikasuhin yung programa sa agrikultura, because at the end of the day, we're still an agricultural country, no? At marami tayong magagawa, no? Hindi lamang yung ano, planting rice, no? Mayroong mga other crops, and there can be mechanization, modernization processes na pwedeng gawin, so that yung particular na piece of land can yield the better and higher results, no? Mm-hmm. Hindi yung traditional, no? So I think this is one of the directions na nakikita ng ating pangulo, and we will really be also doing our share, no? Meron tayong tinatawag na decent work country program, no, where there are specific undertakings na dapat gawin. We are now revisiting that country program document, Mike, no? Mm-hmm. And all of these things, we take into consideration yung mas stabler, better paying jobs, quality, and then jobs that can encourage our Filipino people to stay on rather than think about or even aspire for overseas employment.
Mm-hmm. You did mention in a previous interview with Ms. Karen Davila about your preference to have Filipinos work here in the Philippines, but how to do that, Secretary Laguesma, particularly with respect to the agriculture and forestry sector, which has lost 733,000 jobs, according to the latest report of the PSA. Are there any immediate steps that you are going to take?
Well, the immediate step is to review ano ba yung mga programa natin diyan. Why is the results like this, no? Mm-hmm. Kasi we cannot just think of another program without really reviewing and reinventing the wheel. But mm-hmm. you know, we will also be guided by what you mentioned, statistics, implementation in the ground. What are the deficiencies by the implementing agencies, no? And what are policies in place that would actually encourage na dito na sila? Dahil even our own laws, yung pang vintage na 1995, yung RA 8042, one of the state policies there is option ang overseas employment. But as we go along, move on from 1995 up to the present, parang siya ay pangunahing gustong puntahan ng ating manggagawa. And that necessitated carving out from the Department of Labor Employment a Department of Migrant Workers, no? So there is now a focus for the DOLE, Department of Labor and Employment, to take into account ano ba yung mga concerns sa local employment arena. Mm-hmm. And then Department of Migrant Workers to do its share on actually addressing concerns and issues vis-a-vis overseas employment, no? So ito, there are really tough challenges ahead, but I'm confident and optimistic that with the sectors, no, uniting with us, no, helping us, cooperating, and it's also doing some sacrifices, kasi hindi naman pwedeng agaran na benepisyo makikita kagad natin, eh. There are some sacrifices, but this should be mutually shared in the same manner that benefits derived out of it should be mutually shared.
Mm-hmm. Secretary Laguesma, let me just get your thoughts on two key issues that were raised during the campaign with respect to labor workers. For instance, the issue of national minimum wage. Do you think it's feasible to set a uniform minimum wage for the entire country at, say, 750 pesos, as some are suggesting?
I have always stated, Mike, that, I admire and I salute those who crafted the RA 6727 the Wage Rationalization Act, no? Ito kasi ang direksyon dahil nandoon yung mga factors to consider in regional minimum wage fixing, no? The idea really is the intention or objective was to induce countryside development. Kasi pagkakaiba naman ng level ng development ng mga regions, Mike, and you are pretty aware of that, no? Mm-hmm. Yung iba medyo kulang sa infrastruktura, no? Lalo na ngayon sa panahon ng advanced technology, no? So how do you induce countryside development if you cannot have some differentiation, no? At least to encourage or inspire investors to consider a particular region as the site of their investment, no? And then the other thing is that one of the factors stated in the law is employment generation and family income. So I believe Mike that you know, if we just look into all the factors, no, any adjustments in the wage will appropriately or not perfect. I would state that in advance, no. Medyo masasalat niya o makikita niya ano ang COP, what is appropriate to allow the concerns ng mga manggagawa and also afford opportunity for the employers to be able to expand their business and create more jobs, no? But at the same time, making their operations viable. I'm always misquoted when I say kailangan may rate of investment, reasonable rate of return sa investment. And that's actually one of the basic reasons why investors, mga employers, naglalagak ng puhunan, di ba? They also look forward into being able to expand, get a fair return of their investments. And in fact, even our constitution recognizes yung karapatan ng mga mamumuhunan to a fair return of their investments, no? So kailangan lang siguro there should be mutual sharing ng benepisyo. Pag kumikita ang negosyo, dapat magbahagi sa mga manggagawa.
Lastly, Secretary Leguesma, what about job contracting? Because there have been issues about ENDO. Supposedly they said it's already it's already been abandoned, the concept of ENDO, but they're saying that the use of middlemen, the use of labor-only contracting is now an issue, manpower agencies.
Labor-only contracting is not really allowable. Okay, nagsusupply ka lang ng manpower. But
Secretary Leguesma?
Sorry for the interruption. But under the labor code itself, legitimate contracting of jobs is allowed and not prohibited, no? Recognize ya. I think what I see to be the friction point is the abuses in actually availing of this kind of an arrangement. You very well know that there are work that are project based, like in the construction, basis of work, natatapos, no? So hindi pwedeng tuloy-tuloy, no? Depende dun sa kung kailan na matapos. And there are also other forms of work, seasonal, no? Kailangan mo ng katagdagan. One idea I broached with the employers group was, can you also consider regular seasonal workers? Which means the pool will be the ones that have the preference, yung tinatawag natin, Mike, ba, na right of first refusal. Kung merong available na trabaho, dahil meron naman silang kasanayan, merong skills, investment ang training, Mike, as you are aware, no? So sayang naman kung hindi mo pa magamit, no? But also, there is the reality na hindi tuloy-tuloy ang trabaho. Yes. So that's one approach na pwedeng tignan dito. Pero part ng aming review would be the issuances related to what you term as ENDO. Kaya sumama yung legitimate contracting dahil dun sa practice na pag malapit lang ma-regular, tini-terminate. Yung engagement. That should not be the situation. If workers are qualified and eligible based on their performance to be regularized, I think we will have to make an issue na dapat ang mga employers should regularize them. No? Dapat mahinto yung ganong klaseng abuso. Dahil kinikilala naman ng batas na pwede sila doon sa mga trabaho na talagang seasonal lamang, no? Mayroong phases of work, Pero yung mga trabaho na talagang yan ay tuloy-tuloy na ginagawa. Yan talaga yung sinasabi natin, Mike, na part ng core business.
Mm-hmm.
Eh dapat siguro naman bigyan natin ng pagkakataon ng mga manggagawa na maging regular, ma-enjoy, no? At sa akin naman, tanawagan ko sa manggagawa, pag na-regular, dapat mas masipag, mm-hmm. mas may matasakit, no? Ayun, dapat balance ang bigyan natin ng pakiusap o panawagan ng employer. Bigyan din natin naman karampatan panawagan sa mga manggagawa kasi one of the common issues na sinasabi sa akin pag na-regular na, hindi na ganun kasing sipag. Eh. Mm-hmm. Hindi na kasing... Pero I take issue on that. No? I take issue on that. Dapat lang siguro ipaabot sa mga manggagawa ano ba ang mga responsibilities nila. Kung meron silang karapatan, there will be corresponding obligations. In the same manner that the employers also have prerogatives, pero meron din silang duty and obligation.
Mm-hmm. All right, tough job ahead of you, Secretary Laguesma. I wish you luck on your new post and congratulations.
Thank you, Mike, and thank you for the well wishes. Mabuhay po ang inyong programa.